Har Har Gange, Har Har Gange, Jai Ma Gange, Jai Ma Gange. Devi Sureshwari Bhagavati Gange, Tribhuvan Tarini Tarala Tarange. Shankaramali Viharini Vimale, Mama Mati Rastim Tava Pada Kamale. Jaya Ma Gange, Jaya Ma Gange, Jaya Ma Gange, Jaya Ma Gange. प्रिय दिव्यात्मन, नवरात्र के पावन अवसर पर आप पावन भूमि ऋषिकेश हरिद्वार से हिमालय की पहाड़ियों का दर्शन कर रहे हैं और इन्हीं पहाड़ियों के नीचे साथ साथ पतित पावनी त्रिभुवन तारिणी माँ गंगा प्रवाहित हो रही हैं। उन्हीं की छोटी छोटी सामने धाराएं भी दिख रही हैं। छोटी सी मूल धारा थोड़ा सा 200 मीटर 100 मीटर 200 मीटर पीछे में है, लेकिन माँ गंगा की ही धारा ये क्षेत्र है। देवी सुरेश्वरी भगवती गंगे त्रिभुवन तारिणी तरल तरंगे शंकर मौली विहारिणी विमले मम मतिरस्तिम तव पद कमले। ऋषिकेश हरिद्वार का जो मौसम रहता है उसके अनुपात में पिछले 3-4 दिनों से काफ़ी गर्मी पड़ रही थी। आज दोपहर में जोरों की बारिश हुई तो उसके बाद से थोड़ा जो हिमालय दर्शन बड़ा सुरम्य हो जाता है। बदली कुहासा धूल ये सब छंट जाते हैं, तो मैंने सोचा कि नवरात्रि के पावन अवसर पर आपको इस पावन पवित्र ऊर्जा का थोड़ा दर्शन कराऊं। आप सभी सनातन धर्मियों को नवरात्रि की कोटिशह बधाई। आप सबके लिए नवरात्रि मंगलमय हो। यह नवरात्रि का अवसर असत्य से सत्य की ओर गमन करने का एक सुअवसर है। यह नवरात्रि का अवसर अंधकार से प्रकाश में जाने का एक संकल्प लेने का अवसर है। यह नवरात्रि का अवसर जो मृत है, जो मरण धर्मा है, यह शरीर और शरीर के जितने संबंध हैं और यह जगत, उस मरण धर्मा शरीर बोध से अमर तत्व जो आत्मा है उसमें प्रविष्ट हो जाने, उसका साक्षात्कार कर लेने के संकल्प का सुअवसर है। तात्विक दार्शनिक तो अर्थ नवरात्रि का यही है। प्रत्येक त्यौहार उत्सव महोत्सव तिथि प्रत्येक क्षण सनातन धर्म में कणकण आवाहन कर रहा है आपका अपनी उस विराट वैभव को उपलब्ध हो जाने का। युगों युगों से आपने अपने आप को अज्ञानवश क्षुद्र मरण धर्मा शरीर मान करके बहुत कालों तक प्रताप से ग्रस्त रहे हैं, लेकिन अब समय है कि आप इसका अतिक्रमण करें और सत्चित आनंद, जो तीन संकल्प मैंने कहा, असत्य से सत्य की ओर, अंधकार से प्रकाश की ओर और मृत्यु से अमरत्व की ओर, और ये उपलब्ध होने वाली जो सत्ता है, जो वेदों ने उपनिषदों ने एक शब्द में ही जिसे अभिव्यक्त किया उसे कहते हैं सच्चिदानंद, सत्चित आनंद, द इटर्नल एग्जिस्टेंस, प्योर कॉन्शियसनेस एंड इटर्नल ब्लिस, दैट इज योर सुप्रीम ऑब्जेक्टिव, दैट इज द परम पुरुषार्थ। एंड एवरी सिंगल अपॉर्चुनिटी a festival or occasion, an obligation is subsidiary to that supreme goal, the supreme goal of the realization of your true nature. Sacchidananda. Sacchidananda is your supreme destiny. That is called Paramatman, Brahman, Moksha, Vishnu Pada Parampada. So, unless and until you realize that supreme blissful state of yours, right now, right here, not after death of this body, you can realize, and that is called aparokshanubhuti, that direct, personal, immediate experience of your true nature must happen before death. There is no possibility, and entire Vedantic literature declares this with uplifted arms boldly, that anything and everything has to happen before the death and departure of this physical mortal body. The immortal identity and personality of yours has to be realized, to be attained here before the departure of the body. Not after the death or departure of this body are you going to go to some other loka, the heaven or the moksha. No. Heaven you may, as per your prarabdha karma, but the supreme goal in Sanatan Dharma, the moksha, param purushartha, has to be attained and realized in this lifetime before death and departure of this body. So, once again, on this sacred occasion of Navaratri, let me invite you, let me invoke you, and let me remind you that this sacred obligation, the supreme obligation of each one of us, is to become that supreme reality, the eternal, immortal, cosmic truth. Only then the true deliverance, the true freedom happens. Chidananda Rupah Shivoham Shivoham. You are doing live darshan of the Himalayan foothills from Rishikesh. For the last 3-4 days, by the standards, temperature standards of Rishikesh Haridwar, it was too hot. But today, Rishikesh Haridwar and most parts of Uttarakhand were lashed with very good rain. So now it's clear sky, that's why you can see. Otherwise it used to be hazy, so it wasn't possible to do darshan of the Himalayan foothills and the streams of the Ganga, small stream. The main stream is just 100 meters away from this stream that you are watching. Tomorrow maybe I'll enable you, facilitate for you the direct live darshan of Mother Ganga. So let's realize our true obligation, the supreme obligation, along with the day-to-day mundane activity of our lives. We need to and we ought to keep remembering that sacred obligation in the life. Chidananda Rupah Shivoham Shivoham. Chidananda Rupah Shivoham Shivoham. Mano Bodhya Hankara Chittani Naham. Nacha Shrotra Jihave, Nacha Grana Netre, Nacha Vyoma Bhumir, Na Tejo Na Vayuhu. Chidananda Rupah शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम मनोबुद्ध्यहंकार चित्तानि नाहं न च श्रोत्रजिह्वे न च घ्राणनेत्रे न च व्योम भूमिर्न तेजो न वायु चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम न मे प्राणसंज्ञो न वै पञ्चवायु न वा सप्तधातुर्न वा पञ्चकोशः न वाक्पाणिपादौ न चोपस्थपायु चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहम् चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहं चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहम् चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहं चिद चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहं 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 न मे प्राणसंज्ञो न वै पञ्चवायुः न वा सप्तधातुर्न वा पञ्चकोशः न वाक्पाणिपादौ न चोपस्थपायुः चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहम् चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहम् चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहम् न मे रागद्वेषौ न मे लोभमोहौ मदो नैव मे नैव मात्सर्यभावः न धर्मो न चार्थो न कामो न मोक्षः चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहं चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहं चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहम् न मे रागद्वेषौ न मे लोभमोहौ मदो नैव मे नैव मात्सर्यभावः न धर्मो न चार्थो न कामो न मोक्षः चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहम् चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहम् न पुण्यम न पापम न सौख्यम न दुःखम न मंत्रो न तीर्थ न वेद न यज्ञ अहम भोजनम नैव भोज्यम न भक्ता चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम न पुण्यम न पापम न सौख्यम न दुःखम न मंत्रो न तीर्थ न वेद न यज्ञ अहम भोजनम नैव भोज्यम न भोक्ता चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम न मृत्युर्न शंका न मे जाति भेदः पिता नैव मे नैव माता न जन्म न बंधुर्न मित्रं गुरुर्नैव शिष्यः चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम अहम् निर्विकल्पो निराकार रूपो विभुत्वाच्च सर्वत् सर्वेन्द्रियाणां न चासंगतं नैव मुक्तिर्न मेयः चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहं चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहं चिदानंदरूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंदरूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम दिस वाज निर्वाण शतकम द मोक्षा और द सुप्रीम फ्रीडम दैट इज द objective of these six verses, the entire Advaita Vedanta is encapsulated in these six verses composed by Shankara, the child, 7-year-old child who later become the great Jagat Guru Adi Shankaracharya. He introduced himself for the first time to his Guru Acharya Govindpad when he asked, "My dear child, who are you?" And then he recited these verses. They are two very revolutionary introductions. This is the one. The second is of Hastamalaka and Adi Shankaracharya dialogue. When Adi Shankara asked Hastamalaka, the dumb child, "Who are you?" Then he again introduced similarly, rather more a revolutionary and radical introduction of a child. When Adi Shankara asked, let me recite a couple of the verses from that also, and then this I keep repeating as a Paramhansa Sanyasi, this is the sadhana I am supposed to do. Every moment of mine has to be in the resolution, reaffirmation, reconnection with the pure consciousness, that's all. And breaking free all the relationships from the gross, inert, insentient world of the names and the forms. So when Adi Shankara asked the child, "Kastvam shisho kasya kuto siganta kim namate tvam kutaya gatosi?" एतन्मयोक्तं वदचार्भकत्वं मत्प्रीतये प्रीतिविवर्धनोऽसि. हस्तामलक उवाच, नाहं मनुष्यो न च देवयक्षौ न ब्राह्मण क्षत्रियवैश्यशूद्रा न ब्रह्मचारी न गृहीवनस्थो भिक्षोर्न चाहं निजबोधरूपः भिक्षुर्न चाहं निजबोधरूपः भिक्षुर्न चाहं निजबोधरूपः. निमित्तं मनश्चक्षुरादिप्रवृत्तौ निरस्ताखिलोराधि आकाशकल्पः रविर्लोकचेष्टा निमित्तं यथायः स नित्योपलब्धिस्वरूपोऽहमात्मा स नित्योपलब्धिस्वरूपोऽहमात्मा स नित्योपलब्धिस्वरूपोऽहमात्मा. I am that eternal, immortal, transcendental self of the nature of the pure consciousness. I am ever-present, ever-available reality, beyond all attachments, beyond all sorrows and sufferings, beyond death and birth, decay and disease. I am that ever-present, illuminating and revealing light of pure consciousness. This is my true introduction, this is my ultimate reality, that I am, that I am. These sacred Navaratras are a sacred occasion for each one of us to take a resolve to embark on the noble, most sacred journey of this, attaining these three elements. Though the Supreme Brahman is beyond all attributes, yet for understanding and comprehending in empirical sense, the Vedas and Upanishads have described the Brahman, the Nirguna Nirakara Brahman, as Sacchidananda, the eternal existence, pure consciousness and everlasting bliss, unconditioned bliss. Bliss contains love, bliss and beauty. Unconditioned love, everlasting beauty and absolute joy. That is intrinsic and inherent to your true nature. Every single sorrow and suffering you have been inflicted with is inflicted by your own mind, by the ignorance of yours, by illusory and artificial affiliations you have ascribed to your body. Therefore, in a nutshell, the heart and soul of entire Advaita Vedantic sadhana lies in breaking free mentally and verbally from all the relationships based on this illusory identity called body, and reaffirming, reconnecting and re-establishing firmly the relationship with the pure consciousness, the Atman, that is popularly known as Atman. That is your true nature. None can do it for you. During this Navaratra, you can bring about a radical and revolutionary transformation in your own life by understanding the philosophical depth and yet the simplicity of the process, provided you are an honest seeker, a spiritual seeker, If you are a hypocrite, no one and nothing can solve your problem, no one can deliver anything. And majority of human beings fall in that category, the category of hypocrites. They pretend to be the seekers, the mumukshus, but yet even the path of the truth, the quest for the truth also is a means, becomes a means of fulfillment of their carnal desires, the sensual pleasures, the worldly glamour and glory becomes the means, objective, even through this journey. Therefore, in your moksha or enlightenment or supreme freedom, every single external factor or agency is secondary. You, your willpower, your firm resolve is most central. None can harm or hinder your path as you, your hypocrisy, your false promises to yourself. You yourself are the greatest enemy of yourself, and you alone are the greatest friend of yours. It depends upon yours. The external world, the enmity and friendship in the external world is a reflection of your own understanding about your personality, the objective, the life. The philosophy, attitude and approach to your life is defined and designed by you and you alone. You have the power. You must have the self-confidence to design, script your own story. And that story is a sacred story, the transcendental, eternal story of the Shiva. You are eternal Shiva, immortal Shiva, transcendental Shiva, cosmic Shiva, beyond death and birth, intrinsically blissful. You are embodiment of unconditional love. You are embodiment of everlasting beauty. You are embodiment of infinite joy and bliss. But you are begging in the external world for a single drop of love, bliss and beauty. An iota of grandeur and glory you are begging for. But you are the supreme glory of the creation. You are the emperor of the emperors, and yet you are living like a beggar. Divine selves must hear the courage, as Ashtavakra says. This doesn't behove you. You are the Lord of the Lords, God of the Gods, Governor of the Governors. You are the Supreme Reality. It doesn't behove of you to keep begging and living like a beggar. You are eternal emperor. You are the emperor of emperors, God of the gods, Lord of the lords. As the seer, as the self of the nature of pure consciousness, and that emperor is ever present within you every moment. It is not subject to any great penance or anything else. Just you must have a pure heart. Pure heart is defined. It took 30 years for me to realize the true meaning of the pure heart or pure mind. Pure heart or pure mind is nothing but a mind and heart free from desires. A mind free from all desires is ready to realize, to experience immediately, personally, directly that supreme emperor of emperors who is always present there inside you, as the revealer and illuminator of every single of experience of yours. The moment I am speaking and you are hearing there, that revelation and illumination is happening in, upon and through that pure consciousness. That is the Paramatman, that is the Brahman, that is the Supreme Reality, that is blissfulness, and that pure light is your true nature. That is nameless, formless and attributeless. That is the Atman that has to be realized. Go deep inside. realize your true nature. Keep working in whatever the station of life you are, but keep also in mind that this is a temporary, illusory identity, and the life, the so-called, what you say, the real life experience, the practical life experience, the so-called practical life experience, or the reality, or the truth of your life is all false, imagined by your mental modifications. All the relationships, the network of relationships in the phenomenal world you have created is nothing but your mental creation. Your world is substantially and ultimately nothing but a mental creation of yours. It doesn't exist in reality, but you have assumed all these things exist in imaginary worlds. The mental modifications have distracted you from your true nature, that is immortal, eternal existence, pure consciousness, light of awareness, vast spacious awareness, pure intelligence, your true nature, and bliss is your birthright, which you are seeking in the external world and you have never found. Ashtavakra says that millions and millions of births you have taken, you had millions and millions of wives, husbands, children, empires, wealth, glory, and yet you are hungry, you are begging. They are not going to satisfy you because it's all illusory. The real one is there, ever sitting within you, and in fact, knocking every moment at your back, invoking and inviting you to be one with that supreme reality. You don't have to attain anything external. You don't have to achieve or realize anything from the other world or external world. Your own lost glory has to be retrieved and recovered. The lost empire of yours has to be regained. The self-realization is not an attainment or achievement of some otherworldly, transcendental, intangible, invisible experience or domain or world, but your own true nature, the lost glory of the lost empire of the self, Atma Samraj, what the Upanishads called. You are the emperor of the empire of the self. Jo anant आत्म साम्राज्य है उसके सम्राटों के सम्राट हो परंतु तुम्हारी विस्मृति हो गई है और तुमने अपने को भिखारी मान रखा है मान लिया है और यही मान करके तुम जीवन जी रहे हो ये तुम्हारी मूल अविद्या है तुम्हारा मूल अंधकार है इस अंधकार से परे जाने परे गए बिना तो आनंद की संभावना नहीं है चिंताओं से मुक्ति शोक से मुक्ति त्रैताप से मुक्ति संभव नहीं है इसलिए यह जो नवरात्रा का शुभ अवसर है पावन अवसर है और इस तरह से प्रत्येक महीने कभी शिवरात्रि है कभी एकादशी है ये जो सुअवसर हैं पावन अवसर हैं पावन तिथियां हैं उस पावन तत्व को उपलब्ध हो जाने के संकल्प और आवाहन करने के निमित्त हैं परंतु हम अपनी वासनाओं में सांसारिकता में इतने गहरे रूप से धस गए हैं डूब गए हैं कि जब यह परम पावन जो तत्व चैतन्य तत्व है जो समय और अवधि उसे उपलब्ध होने की है उस उपासना में भी कहीं न कहीं हम वासना को ही खोज रहे होते हैं उस राम की खोज में भी कहीं न कहीं काम हमारा अभिष्ट हो जाता है उस योग के माध्यम से भी कहीं न कहीं भोग ही अभिष्ट हो जाता है ये पाखंड है हमारा
और वह पाखंड हमारे बंधन का, दुखों का सबसे बड़ा कारण है। उस पाखंड से मुक्ति, उस पाखंड से स्वतंत्र होकर इस नवरात्र के पावन अवसर पर यह संकल्प लेना है और यात्रा प्रारंभ करनी है उस परम वैभव की, उस परम वैभव की जिसमें आप अपने ही परम स्वरूप को, शाश्वत तत्व को जान लेते हैं, उसे उपलब्ध हो जाते हैं। जानना ही हो जाना है, उपनिषदों ने कहा ब्रह्मविद ब्रह्मही भवति। तो यह संकल्प हमें लेना है और उस यात्रा को प्रारंभ करना है। यह यात्रा अंतःपुर की है, अंतःकरण की है, यह कोई बाह्य यात्रा नहीं है। यह जो अनंत साम्राज्य और अनंत गौरव आनंद का अनंत भंडार आपके अंदर जो छिपा हुआ है और जो ऐश्वर्य का अनंत खजाना आपके अंदर पड़ा है और आप अपने को भिखारी मान रखे हो, उसी को उपलब्ध हो जाने का आह्वान है। इस नवरात्र के पावन अवसर पर मैं यही उम्मीद करता हूँ कि आप दूसरे के साथ न्याय करें, समाज के साथ, सभी संबंधों के साथ में, राष्ट्र के साथ, परंतु आपका जो परम कर्तव्य है, परम पावन कर्तव्य, वो अपने प्रति है, जिसे परम पुरुषार्थ कहा। आत्मनो मोक्षार्थम जगत हिताय च, द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ लाइफ इन सनातन धर्मा, इन वैदिक कल्चर इज टू फोल्ड, द वेलफेयर ऑफ द सेल्फ, दैट इज द लिबरेशन ऑफ द सेल्फ बाई नोइंग द ट्रू नेचर ऑफ द सेल्फ, दैट इज कॉल्ड मोक्षा, एंड द सेकेंड बट साइमल्टेनियस ऑब्लिगेशन विच इज अ मीन्स फॉर दैट सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन इज constantly working for the welfare of the world, for the society, that is called by Lord Krishna in Bhagavad Gita as Yagyarth Karma. The actions performed for the welfare of the others become Yagna. Every single act of yours, mental, verbal and physical, if it is aimed at welfare of the others, it becomes an act of yagya, a sacred obligation, because in that act of intending to do good for others, ultimately you break free from the chain of self-centered anadya vidya, beginningless nascence, whereby the ego has created a false, illusory personality in you, the sense of self. Thereby you realize that there is no self, isolated, fragmented self. You are a cosmic, universal, transcendental, immortal reality, and therefore the entire universe is your own manifestation. So when you are serving the fellow humans, the fellow society, the society you live in, or the nation, or the entire humanity, or the world, you are ultimately serving yourself. The service to others is essentially a service to yourself, because there is no other. If you go deeper in the texts of Advaita Vedanta, you realize that the entire existence is one, non-dual. There is no duality. Every single dual appearance is imaginary, the mental creation, an illusion and projection of the mind. Therefore, the best way for deliverance or freedom or realization of your true nature is while living in this world, keeping focused on that self-welfare. You must keep working for the welfare of whosoever and wheresoever and whensoever you come across, because the Narayan alone, the Supreme Lord alone, is manifesting in the entire physical phenomenal world of duality. There is none but you. The Narayan is ever present within you, and that Narayan alone has manifested in every single objective appearance of the phenomenal world. Therefore, by serving others, you end up serving yourself, you begin to reaffirm your true identity with the pure consciousness, the Atman, and that is the sacred obligation. So on this sacred occasion of Navaratri, let's take a resolve, firm resolve, to begin that most glorious journey of our life, the journey from falsehood to truth, the journey from darkness to light, the light eternal, the light of pure consciousness, the journey from sadness, sorrow and suffering to the journey of the infinite ocean of love, bliss and beauty, the blissful empire. That is our destiny and that is our birthright. That is possible right here. It is not possible for the other species, but the humans being provided and programmed with the discriminating faculty called mind can discriminate between the right and the wrong, the false and the illusory, the eternal and ephemeral, and thereby enter into that supreme realm of supreme truth, which is the supreme glory, and that is the greatest obligation, most sacred obligation of every follower of the Sanatan Dharma. Rather, every human being. In fact, human beings alone are, since provided with that discriminating faculty, so they, by their own choice, the eternal dichotomous and relationship or debate about dialectics of the free will versus the destiny, essentially one, you alone script your destiny by your own actions. The kind and quality of your actions, the mental, verbal and the physical actions of yours, every moment are creating your own destiny and your own world. Every human being has his, her own world. Panchadashi, one of the seminal texts of Advaita Vedanta, delves deeper in this issue. Every human being, by the approach, by the attitude of theirs, is creating his or her world. So it is up to you. Let me hope and pray on this occasion, during this sacred occasion of Navaratra, that you realize the grandeur of that supreme obligation called moksha, that is the self-realization or God-realization, because that alone is the supreme success. Every single success in the ephemeral world, in the so-called practical life, is illusory, nothing more than a dream. The more you get, the less you become. The more you enjoy, the more hungry you become, because it's all false. Therefore, the true contentment, the everlasting bliss and beauty and love is possible only and only when you come to realize your true nature. Go deeper within and realize your true nature. This Navaratri is inviting you and invoking you from this sacred land of Rishikesh Haridwar, from the banks of Mother Ganga, in the foothills of the Himalayas. I wish and pray that each one of you take a firm resolve to attain that supreme glory, the ultimate success, that is the supreme obligation of yours, becoming all of all in all by yourself, and that is the true self-realization. After realizing your true nature, nothing remains to be achieved. Nothing remains to be known, nothing remains to be done. Because by knowing your true nature, you become everything. That is the Brahman, the Paramatman, the supreme thing. And that is a wholesome and fulsome reality that lacks nothing, needs nothing. It's an eternal, infinite reality. After realizing and attaining that, nothing remains to be achieved, nothing remains to be known, nothing remains to be enjoyed, because in enjoying that one, you end up enjoying everything and everyone, because the one self is the self of all. सच्चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहम् अहो अहं नमो मह्यं यस्य मे नास्ति किञ्चन अथवा यस्य मे सर्वं यद्वाक्मनसगोचरम् अकर्ताहम् अभोक्ताहम् अविकारोऽहमाक्रियः शुद्धबोधस्वरूपोऽहम् केवलोऽहम् सदाशिवः केवलोऽहम् सदाशिवः केवलोऽहम् सदाशिवः सर्वभूतान्तरस्थाय नित्यमुक्तचिदात्मने प्रत्यक्चैतन्यरूपाय मह्यमेव नमो नमः नारायणोऽहं नरकान्तकोऽहं पुरान्तकोऽहं पुरुषोऽहमीशः अखण्डबोधोऽहमशेष साक्षी निरीश्वरोऽहं निरहं च निर्ममः निरीश्वरोऽहं निरहं च निर्ममः ॐ श्री परमात्मने नमः ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं पुनः एक बार सभी सनातन धर्मियों को नवरात्रि की कोटिशः बधाई नवरात्रि मंगलमय हो और आपके जीवन में जो मंगल का आधार अधिष्ठान और स्रोत है वह जो चैतन्य तत्व है उसका अवतरण हो वहीं राम हैं वहीं कृष्ण हैं वहीं विष्णु हैं रामावतार का यही तात्पर्य है आपके अंतःपुर से उस राम का अवतरण हो जाए जन्म हो जाए जो चैतन्य तत्व है जो समस्त जड़ जगत को प्रकाशित करता है और यह अवसर उस चैतन्य को उपलब्ध अवतरित होने और उपलब्ध हो जाने का बने यही मेरी कामना है चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं 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 चिदानन्दरूपः चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूपः चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं 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 चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूपः
शिवोहम शिवोहम। ओम सर्वशक्ति महामाया दिव्य ज्ञान स्वरूपिणी नव दुर्गे जगन्मातर प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहु। जयंती मंगला काली भद्रकाली कपालिनी दुर्गा क्षमा शिवा धात्री स्वाहा स्वधा नमस्तुते। जयत्वं देवी चामुंडा जय भूतारतिहारिणी जय सर्वगते देवी कालरात्रि नमोस्तुते। प्रथमं शैलपुत्री च द्वितीयं ब्रह्मचारिणी तृतीयं चंद्रघंटेति कुष्मांडेति चतुर्थकं पंचमं स्कंदमातेति षष्ठमं कात्यायनीति च सप्तमं कालरात्रीति महागौरीति चाष्टमं नवमं सिद्धिदात्री च नवदुर्गाः प्रकीर्तिताः उक्तानि तानि नामानि ब्रह्मणैव महात्मना ब्रह्मणैव महात्मना ब्रह्मणैव महात्मना। नमश्चण्डिकाय नमश्चण्डिकाय नमश्चण्डिकाय। शिवोहं शिवोहं चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं 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 चिदानन्दरूपः शिवोहं शिवोहं।